father and his men had sent messengers from time to time to the planets of this solar system to regulate more or less the process of existence of the three brain beings arising there, and to bring it into accord with the general world harmony. And thus to one of the planets of this solar system, the planet called Earth, a messenger was once sent from our endlessness. A certain Ashiata Shimash and his Beelzebub had fulfilled a special task indispensable to his mission, this messenger, upon his return to the sun Absalom, earnestly besought his endlessness to pardon the once young and fiery but now aged Beelzebub. In view of this request of Ashiata Shimash, and also of the modest and conscious existence of Beelzebub himself, our Maker Creator pardoned him and gave him permission to return to the place of his arising. And so it is that now, after a long absence, Beelzebub was again in the center of the universe. His influence and authority, far from having declined during his exile, had on the contrary greatly increased, since all those around him clearly recognized that, thanks to the long years he had spent in unaccustomed conditions, his knowledge and experience had inevitably been broadened and deepened. And so, when events of great importance occurred on one of the planets of the solar system Pandesno, Beelzebub's ancient friends decided to intrude upon him and invite him to the conference concerning these events. And that is why Beelzebub, with his kinsmen and attendants, was now making the long journey on the spaceship Karnak from the planet Caradus to the planet Ravosfredender. At the time to which our tale refers, all those aboard the big spaceship Karnak were occupied either with their duties, or simply with actualizing what is called, active being mentation. Among the passengers one very handsome boy stood out. He was always near Beelzebub himself. This was Hassane, the son of Beelzebub's favorite son, Turi. After his return home from exile, Beelzebub had seen his grandson Hassane for the first time and, appreciating his heart, and also owing to what is called family attraction, had taken an instant liking to him. And as the moment happened to coincide with the time when the reason of young Hassane needed to be developed, Beelzebub, now having a good deal of free time, took charge of the education of his grandson himself, and from then on kept Hassane with him wherever he went. For his part, Hassane so loved his grandfather that he would not stir a step without him, and eagerly absorbed everything he said or taught. As this narrative begins, Beelzebub, Hassane, and Avim, the devoted old servant who always accompanied Beelzebub everywhere, were sitting on the highest cabinet, or upper deck, of the Karnak under the Kalnokrananas, a sort of glass bell, talking among themselves while observing the boundless space. Beelzebub was speaking about the solar system where he had spent many years. He was describing the peculiarities of the nature of a planet called Venus. During the conversation, word was brought to Beelzebub that the captain of the ship wished to speak with him, and Beelzebub gave his consent. Chapter 3. The cause of a delay in the falling of the Karnak. Soon afterward the captain entered and, having greeted Beelzebub with all the ceremony appropriate to one of his rank, said, "Your right reverence, allow me to ask your authoritative advice and inevitability lies directly in the line of our course and will hinder our falling. cosmos, asterisk our ship will be passing through the solar system, Lonic. I know I've listened, but at the very place where our ship must pass, there will also pass, about one filtreno before, the great comet belonging to that solar system and name, the Korg-XL, or, as it is sometimes called, the Mad Gap. So if we keep to our proposed course, we must inevitably cross the space through which this comet will have passed. And as your right reverend certainly knows, this mad comet always leaves a great deal of zilnogrigo in its track, which on entering the planetary body of a being disorganizes most of its functions until all the zilnogrigo has been volatilized. I thought at first, continued the captain, of avoiding the zilnogrigo by steering the ship around this zone, but this would mean a long detour and would greatly prolong our filtreno, in the language of Beelzebub, means a certain period of time of approximately the same duration as what is called an hour on the Earth. Zilnogrigo is the name of a gas similar to what is called on the Earth, cyanic acid. Voyage, on the other hand, to wait somewhere until the zilnogrigo is dispersed would take still longer. Based on these alternatives, I cannot decide on my own what to do, so I am venturing to trouble your right reverence for the benefit of your wise advice. When the captain had finished speaking, Beelzebub thought a moment and then answered. Really, I do not know how to advise you, my dear captain. Ah yes, in that solar system where I existed for a long time, there is a planet named Earth, on which there arose, and still continue to arise, very strange three-centered beings, and among them, on one of the continents of that planet called Asia, there arose a very wise three-brained being named Molinosoredin. For each and every peculiar situation, great and small, in the existence of the beings there,